Breakout Rooms for Microsoft Teams is finally here. For all the tricks to use this feature smoothly in your classroom, follow along. Hi everyone, I'm Sarah from Inkno. If you like watching these videos on keeping up with tech in your classroom, make sure to hit the subscribe button. In this video today, we're going to be going over the feature that everyone's been waiting patiently for, Breakout Rooms in Microsoft Teams. You can use these breakout rooms to easily split up your students into different groups so that they can collaborate with each other right in your online classroom. To use this feature, just make sure you have the latest version of Teams downloaded and you're using the desktop application. Then you're ready to get started. To use the breakout rooms feature in Teams, you're first going to need to set up all of your different rooms. So to do so, you can just go into any of your meetings and click on the breakout rooms icon in the top toolbar. Here you'll see a preview for setting up your rooms. You'll first need to choose how many rooms you want, so you can choose anywhere between 1 and 50 different rooms. But for now, let's just go with 2. And then you can choose to automatically have Teams split up your students into your groups randomly, or you can choose to do so manually. Right now, Teams doesn't have an option for pre-created breakout rooms to roll over into your next meeting. If you find that you regularly have the same students in each group, you can still create channels and do breakout rooms that way. However, it doesn't take long to manually assign students into groups, so we'll go with that and I'll show you guys how quickly it can be done. When the breakout rooms are created, you'll see a side menu for assigning your participants to a room. So you can just drop down on this menu and click the students that you would want to assign to a certain room. You'll see that it does go by pretty fast, so you can just do this as you're introducing the topic for your students. Once all of your students are assigned to a room, there are many different settings that you can customize here. We can first begin by renaming our two different rooms. This way, it'll be a little bit easier to differentiate between them. So to do so, you can just go over to the three dots and click on Rename and then quickly give it a new one. Then you can do the same thing for your other rooms. Oh, it looks like we have a student that's joined the class late. To assign the student to a room, you can go up to the Assign Participants and assign the student in the same way that we did previously. We also have a couple of different room settings. So up in the Breakout Rooms section in Room Settings, you'll see that it's automatically set to move my students into their breakout rooms once the rooms have been opened. This way is a little bit easier, especially for younger students, so that they don't have to go into the breakout room themselves. The second option here is to let my students come back into the main classroom. This way we can all have a discussion together as a class when they're done in their breakout rooms. Unfortunately, this setting isn't a default, so if you do want this, you're going to have to make sure it's checked every time. Back in our breakout room settings, we can also recreate our rooms. So if you've made a mistake at any time during this process, you can click this button and it will delete all of your existing rooms and bring you back to that main page of choosing the number of rooms and if you want it to be done automatically or manually. We can also add rooms whenever you need during your class. If you don't need a room that you've added, you can always just delete it. Once all of your settings are complete and you're ready to begin your breakout rooms, you can open up each room one at a time, or you can start all of them at once. Once these rooms have been started, your students will automatically be pushed out into those rooms. Now that all of my students have made it into their breakout rooms, you can see that I'm alone here in the general meeting. From here, I can still view a quick status update on my students. So it looks like most of them made it into their breakout rooms. However, one has already left or got lost along the way. So we can ask him to join back in. From here, I can also join either of my breakout rooms. And these breakout rooms work just like its own meeting. So all of my students have been brought in as presenters, but just like regular meetings, I can change them to be meeting attendees instead of presenters in the meeting options. From the student side, we can view what it looks like for them. So here you can see that students can open up the chat and type in it along with sharing their screen. So for example, we can open up a whiteboard. And when students type in the chat, you as a teacher will get a notification on your desktop. That way you can monitor how your students are doing. Back on the teacher side, we can return to the general meeting and send our students an announcement. These announcements pushes out the same message to all of the breakout rooms. So this is a really quick way to quickly update your students. So we can just go to the three dots, click make an announcement, and quickly type in the message. Once we hit send, it automatically sends that message to every single breakout room. So let's view that on the student side. So here you can see it's in the meeting chat and it comes with a red exclamation mark and highlights it as important. So all the students will be able to see right away. When it's time for all of your students to come back into the general meeting, if they're not here already, you can close all of the breakout rooms right here. So this will automatically bring all of your students back into our general meeting. When class is over, you can completely end the class for everybody. That way, students aren't staying on the call longer than you. Back in your team, you can view all the chat and the whiteboard and any files students sent between each other in their breakout rooms. So in the chat section of your Microsoft Teams, you can see you have access to all of the different breakout rooms. You can see what your students have chatted about, along with any files they sent or meeting notes and their whiteboard. Students only have access to their specific breakout room, but as a teacher, you have access to every single breakout room. And those are all the tricks I have for you guys on using this new feature of Microsoft Teams. Hopefully, you can implement breakout rooms into your classrooms to let students collaborate much easier than ever before. If you have any other questions on Microsoft Teams, check out the other videos that are linked in the description below. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to give us a thumbs up and hit subscribe.